key next step with this program is to have a so-called end of phase two meeting. So that's where you have a sit down with the agency and align on what the phase three program is going to look like. We have requested that meeting already.
All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Srinivas Rao. He is the CEO of AtaiBeckley NV, and Srini, as we obviously know you as the nickname. Good to see you. How are you?
I am doing well. It's great to see you as well, Steve.
Yeah, so lots to talk about. I mentioned off the top, AtaiBeckley. This is a merger between two companies. When you read the sort of the news release about it, really makes sense. But I'll let you sort of address the reasoning behind this.
Yeah, absolutely. So obviously, we've been involved with Beckley. We were involved with Beckley for quite some time. We had made an investment into Beckley, announced that in January of last year. Very much the reasons were pretty obvious, or should be obvious. I mean, pretty much aligned in the philosophy around psychedelic therapies, really focusing on short duration psychedelic therapies. And very much like the work that the team there was doing on BPL-003, the intranasal 5-methoxy-DMT asset. Announced that we'd be completing a transaction with Beckley, a strategic combination in June that was pending the results of the study. Obviously, the core study results were released in July and were robustly positive, very excited and very exciting to investors, et cetera. So, yes, last week we had our shareholder vote, and that officially resulted in the combination being closed. And now we're officially known as AtaiBeckley.
Yeah, it seemed like everyone, there's a lot of support behind this. And as you mentioned, it seemed like a natural fit right from the beginning. And that's where these things work really well. And so you're already seeing that great synergy between the two companies?
Absolutely. I mean, it's a fantastic team over there. I was on the board for the last 18 plus months, so know the team there very well. Really good synergies between the two folks. Lots of experience. When you put it all together in terms of the number of clinical studies that have been conducted by the two organizations and the number of psychedelic studies, it's a powerhouse team. Okay. And very well set up now to get this into phase three, BPL-003 into phase three.
Yeah. So you've actually reported some top line results from the 2B clinical trial of BPL-003. So maybe you can sort of talk to us about what the trial is doing right now and really what these top line results are telling you.
Yeah, absolutely. So the trial, just to remind everybody, the phase 2B trial had a core segment and then an open label segment. And the core trial was essentially a single administration of BPL-003 at either 0.3 milligrams, which is the functional placebo, 8 milligrams or 12 milligrams. And the primary endpoint on that trial was 4 weeks. And then we followed the patients out to 8 weeks. And those are the results that we reported back in June. Again, a very robust separation between both the 8 and 12 milligram dose versus the 0.3 milligram, the functional placebo. The data that we just released on Monday of this week was the second phase of that. So patients that were eligible, that completed the core study were eligible to go into this open label extension, wherein they got a single administration of 12 milligrams of BPL-003, and then they were followed for another 8 weeks. So that's the data that we reported out. Now, the folks coming into the trial either got into the OLE, got either 0.3 or 8 or 12. Mm-hmm. And what we found is that those that got an active dose, in other words, the 8 or 12 milligram doses in the core study, received 12 milligram in the second and the open label, had a nice beneficial, had a nice incremental bump in their efficacy, very good durability, response and remission rates continue to actually climb as a function of time over the course of this open label extension, particularly with those folks that got 8 milligrams originally and then 12 milligrams in the OLE. And in the functional placebo, those that got 0.3 in the core study saw a nice reduction. It was very similar to what we saw with the active folks in the first part of the trial. So really happy with the results.
Yeah, and I imagine that all these steps that you're taking, very important, and they have to go in line. So what's the next step now that you've got some of the data here? I know there's some things that you're doing in the next little while that will really move this forward.
Yeah, so the key next step with this program is to have a so-called end of phase two meeting. So that's where you have a sit down with the agency and align on what the phase three program is going to look like. We have requested that meeting already, and we are providing guidance that, you know, that we will let the street know what our aligned plan is for the phase three program in the first quarter of next year.
All right. We'll look forward to more of that. Thank you so much. Good to catch up with you, and great information as always, and really appreciate your time.
Thank you. And likewise.
All right. There is Srinivas Rao. He is the CEO of AtaiBeckley NV.